I got more demotivated with the rank. I couldn't understand where I'm standing. Why would I choose it? I thought I chose a wrong decision.
Hello everyone, welcome to Exergic. This interaction is going to be with Satvik Karnati, who comes from Hyderabad. He has done his B.Tech engineering from Vasavi College of Hyderabad, and he passed out in 2019, and this was his third attempt in GATE, right? So situation is little different for him, although he got a job, but he prepared by resigning from the job. So I'm sure there is a lot that you can learn from what mistakes he made or what learnings he can give you for your own preparation. First of all, congratulations for such a great rank. And tell me about your past attempts, that what attempts you made in which year and how was your score in those attempts.
Okay, I graduated from 2019 batch.
All right.
So my first attempt was in 2019 itself, okay, when I'm studying fourth year. Okay. So I secured 65 marks with 2976 rank in the first attempt.
Okay.
Later on, I also placed from a college in a oil and gas based company.
Okay, college placement.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I went through it. I chosen with this rank. I did not secure any IIT, NIT. So I went with the job.
So your target from GATE was to do higher studies.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I thought of managing the job and this GATE preparation. Mm-hmm. So with that, I have given the first attempt. So I thought of giving the second attempt again. So I went through it.
Okay.
So in 2020, I gave my second attempt. But this time things changed. I don't know what happened, but I secured again with the less marks, 57 marks.
Less marks than the first attempt. Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
57 marks with 4576 rank.
In 2020.
2020. Okay. So, right.
It must have been very difficult.
Yeah. I got more demotivated with that rank. I couldn't understand where I'm standing. Why would I choose it? I thought I chose a wrong decision.
Okay.
By taking up this job.
Okay.
So I gave up my job. I resigned.
So you resigned from the job.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is not the right thing, because standing on two boards and managing those.
All right. I can totally understand that, depending because job profiles can be different.
Yeah.
It can be hectic. Boss may not be very good.
So yes.
Situations can be different in different jobs.
Yes.
With some jobs, it's just not possible to prepare parallelly.
Yes.
Right. So you took the decision of resigning.
Yes, okay. Because working 10 hours, 12 hours, so
yes.
I don't have much time to prepare.
Right. If work timing is not allowing you to study even 3 hours a day, 4 hours
yes.
a day, then obviously it's difficult.
So,
okay.
Later on, I thought this was my final attempt, and I gave my 2021 attempt with God's grace and something which all exergic thing.
Right.
I secured 90 marks in GATE 2021.
Great. So I'm sure this must have been a pressure situation for you.
Yeah.
Last ball, six marna, that type of situation.
Yeah.
So how did you handle that pressure? Because you resigned from a job, stakes were high.
Yeah.
I'm sure your family, friends will be expecting that this time you have to do it.
Yes.
So how did you handle that pressure?
Yeah, we can compare similarly to a hydrostatic pressure, the body in the ocean.
Okay.
So one pressure is from family.
Right.
You left your job, I will not do anything for you. So all you want to know, you should stand on your own legs, like similarly.
Mm-hmm.
And another pressure is from friends, because they will expect a higher rank. Because I secured a good rank in the previous attempts,
mm-hmm.
they will expect a good rank, because you are taking 1 year time,
mm-hmm.
and you should secure a very good rank.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, something.
Yeah, yeah.
And more and more pressure is myself. Because
myself, the biggest one.
Yeah. Because the pressure comes from when we score less marks in the tests, in the
mm-hmm.
test series.
Yes.
So we get more demotivated. Why I'm doing like this?
Uh-huh.
Because this is my third attempt, I should score by out of 25, out of 25, 100 out of 100. Like,
right. That's the expectation at least.
But I'm scoring less. So what's this?
So final. How did you manage that?
Yeah, I...
What pushed you? How did you kept yourself going?
I used to watch your motivation videos.
Okay.
Whenever I used to get less marks, I used to watch your video.
Okay.
A repetitive video. It may be I have seen that videos like 30 to 40 times only for the motivation itself.
Okay.
Yeah, later on for the motivation purpose. And if I scored less marks, I used to analyze what was wrong with me,
mm-hmm.
whether it is a silly mistake or whether it's a conceptual mistake, or that some new concept, in a new way of asking a question. So I took up complete strategy, because while I was preparing in my fourth year, I just went to the coaching center. They used to teach me simply, just like listening in the classes in the engineering college. So I am unable to think practically.
Right.
So what was this?
From the exam point of view, strategy should be there.
Yeah. Yeah. Because nowadays GATE is asking more of practical questions. So exactly. we should implement all of them.
Right.
So that was not a good strategy to approach the practical questions.
Right.
So I thought of changing the strategy. I referred some good foreign other books. So because they will include much more concepts, and I have seen your tests also.
Right.
I used to decode from where you are asking these questions, how you are able to ask these questions in a different manner. So, okay, we can ask in this type of
manner also it can be asked. Yeah. Right. So analysis is very important.
Yeah, I used to in 2020 we have got a question like empirical formula, shear strength and clearance.
Right.
So I did a research on it. Like GATE, the previous IITs are asking the questions in the previous. Like if they ask in 2015, they'll give the formula, empirical formula. Again, they will ask the same question in 2019. They'll ask the formula itself.
Right.
This way I approached again all the previous questions. Okay. So I again came back, okay, they will ask like this also.
All right. So continuously you kept analyzing yourself.
Yeah.
You kept yourself motivated, and rather than feeling bad, you try to analyze that how could I improve further.
Yes.
That was your sole intention once you started solving questions.
Yeah.
As you know that silly mistakes are something that must be controlled, and since you have been through that journey, I'm sure you have made silly mistakes in GATE also. So what were your ways of controlling silly mistakes, avoiding silly mistakes? What tips would you give to aspirants?
Silly mistakes, we majorly come by like many factors. We will get excited by seeing an easy question.
Right.
Like I have done this before. So we will think like that. At any point of pressure, how much pressure it may be on me, like if I have 30 seconds, I can solve the problem. So if we have this type of overconfidence, I am sure that we will make a silly mistake.
For sure.
And then if you have read the concepts, like a half knowledge. So if you have not read the complete thing, you don't know everything completely. So it would, for sure, you will lead to a wrong solution. So don't mug up the formulas. You should know what exactly, for example, let's say a rolling question. What generally people simply mug up the formula is mu is equal to root of delta h. So why and when we apply that formula? Because many of the students, they used to apply directly.
Mm-hmm.
But after seeing your video, there was a reason when we are applying, it will be for a maximum case. So there will be exceptions. So you should need to write down the exceptions when and where we need to apply. So in this manner, we should avoid the silly mistakes. And
having the right conceptual clarity, that also gives you a confidence.
Yes.
That what I am doing is correct.
Yeah.
You don't have to doubt your steps.
Yes.
And the first point that you told, that you don't have to be overconfident by seeing easy questions. Okay,
yes.
Please continue.
And another silly mistakes will be like conversion factors. So in the test series, we will be like, knowing that, well, if you ask a force, you will give the answer 20. So we'll simply give the answer, we'll tick the mark. But the units were 20 Newton mm. It was the units of torque.
It was
wrong answer. So
right.
We should clearly observe what are the units of torque.
Yes. Paying attention basically to what is asked to you in the question. Don't be overconfident. Don't be underconfident. Read it properly. What units are asked.
Yeah.
We pay proper attention to that.
Another mistakes will be like conversions, like percentage, you will ask in percentage. We will be simply putting in the normal decimals. This is a major mistake. I lost huge marks.
I've done this mistake a lot of times.
So many times.
Okay.
Finally, I resolved myself how to overcome this mistake.
Right.
These are the mistakes.
Okay. Now, since you have a preparation journey of 3 years, and all three of them I would call to be different. First one in college, then with job, then full-time aspirant.
Yeah.
So what final tips you will give to aspirants that they should keep in mind, something that they should avoid in this whole journey of yourself? Whatever final tips you will give to aspirants?
My final tips will be majorly for fourth year students, because they want to crack the gate with so much patience. They're like managing the first semesters, everything.
Mm-hmm.
They have most passions in them. So I would recommend them to don't muck up the formulas. So write in notes of yours. Your understanding. So I may understand, I can write in a simple sentence. But if some person could not understand the whole concept, he will write in a paragraph, a whole page.
Mm-hmm.
So understand and write the concepts to your extent and your capabilities. How can you recap them in the future? So it will be the best tip. And I also recommend for mistakes, write down all the possible mistakes. Take a sheet. So if you have attempted 10 mistakes in out of 20 questions, what is a mistake? So conversion, units, proper input, improper data, like everything. What you are committing mistake, you should note down.
Note down all the possible silly mistakes that you can make or that you have made. You have to maintain a sheet of those mistakes.
Yes.
That will keep reminding you not only of the mistake, but also they won't let you get overconfident.
Yes.
That yes, these are the mistakes that I am making.
Yeah.
And you will recommend that final year students.
Yes.
Should be because they have the energy at
less
that time.
Less time.
Yeah.
So they should know what are my mistakes in the time constraints. So before attempting again test, another test.
Mm.
So we will have a sheet in front of us. We will know either we have done this mistake. We have done this mistake. So we should not commit this mistake. It will save the marks for us.
Right, exactly.
This was and we should also segregate the mistakes.
Okay.
Where and why was it conceptual?
Conceptual mistake or calculation mistake.
Yeah.
Or these types of mistakes we should be clear.
Yes.
Okay. So these are the final tips from Sattvik, and I'm sure you got to know some interesting and useful tips. I wish you all the best for all your future endeavors, and I'm sure you will excel and do well in all of them. Best wishes from my side.
Thanks.